Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, Sine Excel function, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So, the Sine function in Excel computes the sine of an angle specifically, and that we specify. So, a Sine in Excel function is categorized as a math, or you can say it's a math or a trig function. In Excel, and Sine in Excel always returns to the numerical value. So in mathematics and trigonometry, we used to use the sine function is a trigonometric function of an angle, which is closely a right triangle, okay, and is equal to the length of the opposite side. So the right angle side is divided by the length of the hypotenuse, and it is represented by sine theta, okay. It's known as the sine theta, which is opposite side, as and the hypotenuse, which is represented. Now, if you just write sine here, you'll get the number that you want to select. Okay, so where the number is basically an argument that is passed in the sine formula in radians, and if you directly pass the angle to the sine Excel function, it will not recognize its valid argument. For example, if we pass 30 degree as the argument to the sine in the Excel function, it will not recognize it as a valid argument. So the Excel will display as an error message. Okay, so make sure that thing. Now, you will use an example to convert a 30 degree to a radian, and we will use the function, and it will take the degree to a number of, it will be 30 degree, closely around the same. How you are going to do? Simple. You just use radian and just write 30 degree, okay, just write this, is equal to radians, write 30 inside this, close the bracket. It should reflect the answer closely around 0.52, it's not reflecting here. So in this case, the radians will be degree into pi divided by 180, where pi is always, we know, 3.14. So in Excel, we have a function that returns the value of a pi, okay, and to accurate of a 15 digit number in the, so therefore for degree to radian conversion, we would use the formula as radian is equal to the degree into p divided by 180. So this is the formula that we will use for calculating this. Now, how to use the sine function in Excel? The sine function in Excel is very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of the sine in the Excel by some of the examples. Now, in this example, sine in Excel, example number one, you need to calculate the sine value using the sine function in Excel and radian function in Excel. How you are going to calculate? You will just write is equal to sine and just use the formula. See, beside this, there is a formula that is given, radians, and you select the angle of the degree that you want, close the bracket, okay, and just drag the things down. Control D, so and so on and so forth, A6. So you will have some output, something like this, like, you know, 0.7, 0.866, 0.5, 0.8191, and then 1. So this is going to be the scenario. Now, calculating the sine value using the sine function in Excel and PI function. So here, what you need to do is that you will need to calculate using a different formula altogether. So what you will do, everything remains the same, you use this formula, okay. Now, instead of the radians here, just delete this. This A2 as the 45 degree angle into PI, okay, returns the value of the PI, that is the pi, close the bracket, divide by 180, close three brackets. Okay, so keep copying this, keep copying the formula, and you will again have the same answer here. Okay, this will be the answer. Just use this formula. So, since the function in Excel has many real-life applications, it is widely used in architecture to calculate the height and the length of the geometric figure. So, it is also used in GPS, optics, calculating trajectories to find the shortest route based on the latitude, longitude, geographical locations, radio broadcasting, and even an electromagnetic wave is plotted as a graph, since as a cosine function. So suppose we have a right angle triangle, and given that there are three angles and length of the one side, we need to calculate the length of the other two sides. Okay, something sort of here, as you can see. So this is how the third angle, first angle is 90 degree, the second angle is 30 degree, and so on and so forth. Third angle will be 180 minus, obviously, the first and the second. Okay, that's very basic. So the sum of the angle on the triangle is has to be 180, and therefore we can easily calculate the third angle. Okay, so now we know that, you know, sine theta is opposite divided by the hypotenuse, right? So the opposite side will be sine theta into hypotenuse. So in Excel, the length of the opposite side is perpendicular side and will be calculated by the sin formula. So the sin formula will be used over here is equal to sin radians, and this is the second angle will be taken into the hypotenuse. Okay, so applying the above, we can get the length of the perpendicular of the triangles. Now for the third side, the adjacent side, if you see, we have two methods, by using the Pythagoras theorem or by using the sine or in Excel function from other angles. So according to the Pythagoras theorem, the sum of the square of the two sides of the right angle triangle is equivalent to the square of the hypotenuse, right? So the hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. So the adjacent is equal to hypotenuse minus opposite. Okay, so in Excel we will write it as is equal to power, use the power function, power e2, that is a hypotenuse, okay, comma 2 as a part of the function that has been, you see over here, this is the power and this is the number, less the power f2, that is the opposite side, minus you are deducting the opposite side, power is 2, okay, and again it's half that you have made. So based on that, applying the formula, we will compute the length of the adjacent triangle. So adjacent side using the Pythagoras theorem and using the sin function, that is, we already know, we have already done the sin function. So using the second method, we can use the sine of the third angle to calculate the value of the adjacent side. And if we rotate to triangle to 90 degree, okay, the left of the opposite side is swapped with the adjacent side, and the sine of the angle between the hypotenuse and the adjacent will be to calculate the third side. Okay, I hope you have got it. Now let's say in this particular example, let's say there is a tall building which is of unknown height, and the sun ray at a point of time makes an angle point A of 75 degrees. Okay, this one. So making a shadow of the building of the length 70 meter, we need to find the height of the tower. How we are going to do 70, 75 and the height that we are supposed to find. So how we are going to find this amount? Okay, that's the whole catch here. So the height of the building will be calculated using the sin in Excel function. Sin is 75 degree, that is the height of the building and the length of the shadow at point A. And therefore the height of the building is equal to sin 75 degree into the length of shadow at point A. Now hence the height of the building will be sin is equal to sin, use the radians function inside this, and take b3 as the value, close both the bracket, into b2, so that will give you 67.61. so the height of the building will be 67.61, and the sin in the Excel example 3, we over here is the length of the triangle for which the two angles are given, 30 and 70. And we only know the length of the one side of the triangle, which is 40 meter. We need to find the length of the other three sides of the parameter of the triangle. So for a triangle, when one side of all the angles are known, we can calculate the other sides of the sin rule. So the sin rule in trigonometry gives a relation of sin angles and the sides of the triangle by a sin formula. So you will need to apply the formula here, and we need to find the balancing figure here. Therefore, the formula will be as simple as that, you know, is equal to sin function you will use inside that radians. The angle is 30 degree, close through brackets, into, open another bracket, b5, divide by sin function again, inside the same radians, use 70, first bracket close, second bracket, and the third bracket, close it, and you will get 21.28. So the length of the side of A is 21.28. Similarly, the third side, C, will be sine theta into the B divided by sine G. So therefore, you know, again, copy down the formula. You know, over here, just change everything to 80 and 70, let it be. So 22.31, right? And over here, instead of B6, it has to be B5. So 41.92. So the three sides of the triangle are the length 21, 28, 40, 41.92. And the parameter of the triangle is the sum of all the sides. Therefore, the parameter is equal to sum of B5 to B7. That is 103.20. So, that's it for this particular topic. I know this was a very heavy topic, but trust me, we have learned great concepts here about sine function. If you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone for attending this session. Cheers.